America where our standards not in Jesus.
They say it's necessary.
Us must believe in Jesus.
I'm all for it. Yes, sir.
That makes a difference.
I'm all for it.
Thank you, sir. You're respect to Europe.
Yes, absolutely. Europe has lost its backbone. They've allowed this fund to take over. And so we see that problem, and our president wants to stop it now. Or it will become a
question. Right. And also, the
guidelines. Anyone takes a picture of
the world. He's without the Europe. Well, we want to take care of America first. We're not the Bank of America that we have to feed everybody. I mean, you have to take care of your own country. And so, he's not going to stop the welfare system. He's going to try to get people to get educated and get a job. That's the concept. I would be honored to have him.
Hey, Jesse, have you got the shot from back here with the military truck in the background?
Israel is our ally in the Middle East. Israel would not exist without
the
500 people. And the only reason we look at Israel is because, again, that line, there's prophecy in
that. And Dr. Trump. But another reason we're here is because we love you and we don't want you to go to hell. We're very aware that many conservatives are not Christians. Very aware that many people here may have believed another gospel. And so we call you to trust God's word and trust what he has said, that you might be converted and you might be saved on that great day of judgment to come. Yes, there's a great day of judgment to come. Jesus Christ said there's a narrow and difficult way and few find it. Right now, each of you are on a narrow path to try and get through this narrow gate to get into this inauguration. Well, likewise, there's a narrow and difficult way that leads to life in the kingdom with Jesus Christ. And that way is to be converted by the Holy Ghost first, that you must confess all your sins and seek the Lord until you're born again by the Holy Ghost. Just seek the Lord until you're born again by the Holy Ghost. Then the next thing you have to do according to God's condition for your life. The next thing you must do is abide in Jesus Christ and love and obey him until you die. Love and obey the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords until the day you expire. In other words, as Jesus said, go and sin no more. Trappier syndrome. The wages of sin is death. For 8 years, we've had Obama as our executive officer. He has been perhaps the most horrible president in our history. He has taken apart the police forces. The state police have been decimated by his order. The military has been decimated by his order. Our freedom has been decimated by Obama and his executive government. Hillary, that wicked witch, finally, she's been put down and humiliated as she should have been 8 years ago. Hillary, responsible for Benghazi gate. Hillary, responsible for Benghazi. Obama, responsible for Benghazi. When our soldiers died because they could not receive the help that was available to them because the orders from the executive branch were stand down. Stand down to the troops. And the troops watched our troops be slaughtered at the hands of Obama and Clinton. And they need to be brought account by Trump's executive branch. Nay, they need to be held accountable by the people. The people must rise up and demand that our government hold that wicked government accountable for what they did. But do you know what the problem with America is right now? America has no moral compass. America has abandoned the Bible, abandoned Jesus Christ for the most part, has allowed the LGBTQXYZ influence into our families, into our states, and into our nation. It is unacceptable, this sexual deviant lifestyle that are destroying the families in our country, which are the very fabric of our nation. Families, godly, marital families, according to God's design, is the very fabric of our culture, the very fabric of our country. And when you violate God's design, then you bring forth judgment. And we believe that militant homosexuality, anarchy, abortion are all judgments from God, because the Christians in this country, this great country we live in, will not rise up and speak against that which God considers to be an abomination. It is an abomination to allow abortion at any point of the pregnancy. That is a life that God is creating within the mother's womb. And if you'll just go to a simple website called abortionknows.org, you can do it on your phones right now. Go to abortionknows.org. But I warn you, in 5 seconds, that video of the abortion of a baby with a woman with her feet up in the stirrup as that abortion doctor chop, chop, chop that baby in pieces. The greatest law-breaking in our society happens every day with killing the most innocent people in our country. The most defenseless people in our country are unborn babies in their wicked mommy's womb. The blood of these children cry out from the ground. And the Bible says in Isaiah that the blood will be uncovered and God will judge the blood. And so we, countrymen, I call you to rise up against this wicked thing that started in 1973. I was 13 years old, I'll never forget it. When that newscaster came on and said that the Supreme Court had approved of abortion, I didn't even understand what it was. But I knew babies were going to be killed. And in 1979, me and my Roman Catholic girlfriend, shacking it up, got pregnant, and guess what we did? Guess what we did to our son? in 1979, we murdered our child legally in America. We murdered our child at 3 months, the first trimester, with an injection.